Hello, everybody. This is Barda from Roosters Peacock, and this is Coffee Time Tarot for the week ending January the 15th, which is this coming Sunday. All right, I'm going to get right on into it. I am going to share a couple links. This, like I said, this is live on Facebook. YouTubers, I will be uploading this immediately after, so you guys can make sure that you get the content for the week. And YouTubers, if you're wanting to, this is being done live on Facebook, so you're welcome to come on over and join Roosters Peacock and Coffee Time Tarot and join in on the conversation. All right. Not always on Sundays am I able to do Coffee Time Tarot, but I thought, you know what? Let's do it. Okay. I'm going to share a link real quick, several of them, make sure everybody else can catch up, and then I'm going to go ahead and put the cards out for you. You guys can say hi when you come on. I can't see you quite yet. Hope everybody's doing good. I don't know about you guys, but yesterday I was not wanting to wiggle. It was kind of a lazy day. I got to share two links here. There it is. Welcome to say hi when you come on. Okay, Coffee Time Tarot for the week ending Sunday, 15th of January. This is just going to be a general reading, so there should be pieces and parts each person should be able to pull out. This is a universal reading. While I am on the live, sometimes I do pick up on people, and so I will say this message is for one person, two people. It might hit four people. I will know as I get going here. Dang, I told you. You know what? I did those readings last week. When I did that one reading, I'm telling you, a lot of people were up in their heads this weekend, big time. And it's not just going to end this weekend. I can tell you that right now. But it's not in the bad direction. They're really evaluating. All right. And for you guys that were asking me about having a place to mail stuff, you know, because I was asking for seeds and stuff like that, I got a P.O. box. It is attached to this video. Okay. Let's see here. So the first card here we have is beauty, truth. Okay, that is literally going to go in one section right there. Okay, then we have travel, forgiveness, well-being. That's going to be another group right there. And what I mean by groups is everybody's an individual, everybody's different, so not every single, like these right here, the beauty and the truth, that's going to hit home with only certain people. Some of you, it's going to be about the travel, forgiveness, and your well-being. And for others, it's going to be some kind of justice that's going to create the happiness within you. Okay, that's another one. Now, when I said people were up in their heads, big time. But the thing with it is, it's not bad. It's not bad at all. I mean, a lot of people were searching this weekend. And especially, for some reason, I feel like saying this, if you had a situation where it was... I feel there was tension. This is not going to go for everybody, but I did pick, and it feels right from the last reading I did last week. There was tension, and it's kind of like you're redirecting your brain in a different direction instead of trying to respond to whatever external factors are going on around you in the same way. You're catching yourself, no matter if somebody's pushing you or if it's just like almost like a reflex reaction, okay? Why? Because we've got, what's the focus? What has been the focus? Not this, and this is being done Sunday, okay? Sunday the 8th, okay? So Coffee Time Tarot for Sunday ending the 8th has already been done. That's up there on Roosters Peacock and Coffee Time Tarot. You guys are welcome to watch that if you haven't watched it already. But this weekend, I'm telling you, people have been really focusing, and it's cleaning out. Literally, I think it's literally getting into that spring cleaning. It's hitting me again. Literally, we've got the home, the focus of the home. And this is not just about a home. This is literally, no matter where you're at, you're making your surroundings, or you're dissatisfied with it to the point that you are going to make your home your home. Okay? So it doesn't matter how great your home is, as far as it doesn't have to be top of the line. It's also who you have around you as well. That's going to be a big one too. There has been a lot of people who have been evaluating stuff that needs to go, whether it's people, places, and things. Excuse me. And this last year, it was all about balance. You'd already started this process last year. But some of you, there's a lot of people that are still regaining balance in certain situations, because sometimes what I'm seeing is somebody on the teeter-totter, and then somebody jumps off and it just makes you fly, right? Or you crash down real hard. Okay, some people are recouping and recovering as well. So, but the year 2023 in general is about peace and regaining peace no matter what's going on around you. All right, and it's not just about you. This is, I keep seeing the flock card in my head, and it shows a bunch of birds on it. And that one right there is talking about, it's not just about you, it's you're focused on other people around you as well. But you're also focusing on your peace and keeping peace within the home, all right? Keeping peace within yourself, just that's the focus. And people do need to keep that in mind for 2023. It is not about peace on the external around, you know, as far as the world itself. It's keeping peace within yourself and within your family, your flock, your friends, you know, your tight-knit people. All right. So anyway, a lot of people have been focusing. You know what? If you're not feeling very peaceful, you're bound determined to get it. I mean, some of you are getting ready to jump off onto what I call the deep end, but it's a good deep end. It's no longer sitting there dissatisfied and continue living where it's just an upheaval. That's what I feel. Dissatisfaction. All right. A lot of people walked into 2023 and they decided that, you know what? I'm going to seek my peace. All right, so a lot of people have already cut people, places, and things out of their lives. Others of you, you're going to be doing it pretty quick. You're already mentally, if you haven't physically done it yet, you're mentally already well on your way. Okay, there's no, what I'm seeing is for some, you're hopping off the fence. Literally, yep. Okay, so the next one right here is blessings. All right, that's going to be a focus for some as well. Blessings, not lessons. Okay, that I just heard that. So a lot of people are going to be focusing more on their blessings than their lessons, because life has been nothing but a continue, you know, they say life is a learning lesson, right? But some of the learning lessons, you're tired of the lessons. So you're trying to focus on the blessings. You want those blessings to come to you. So how do you do that? By creating peace within yourself and your surroundings, your immediate surroundings, the stuff that you, and I'm not going to say control, because control is, the word control is used way too much. But sometimes you do have to take a hold of your own life, and you have to bring that peace, and you have to bring the blessings, and you watch. It's not going to be so much lessons and flies bopping off your face. All right. Still, it's not going to be easy, cheesy. I'm not going to say that through 2023. And I know this is a weekly reading, but this is what's going to be weighing on people's minds all through 2023. All right. Some of you are jumping it on in January because you're well aware life's not going to get easier. So you have to make your own peace. You have to get your own balance, right? And sometimes it's not just about you. It is about there's other people around you. And if there's chaos and conflict, a lot of you are tired of chaos and conflict. Some of you said goodbye to that in last year and said, no, I'm not doing it anymore. Everybody's going to work together. Some of you, I'm seeing something about friends. You literally have cut friends off, all right? Some of you family, but that for some reason that was going to get hit home. The next card we have here is compassion, all right? Now that stands alone right there. Ooh, nice, okay. Some of you may have commitment on your mind. Some of you it has to do with love. Some of you it has to do with self-love or being able to love again. Some of you are working on clarity. All right, you're seeking the answers. Some of you with the clarity card right here, do you see the bubble around? Okay, that bubble's about to be burst. You're about to see clarity. And this one right here says spirit guide, which can represent spirits, but it also, do you see right here, do you see the two of them? All right, some have had a bubble around them literally to where they're protecting themselves. And feeling upside down, you know, it's back and forth. You're getting ready to switch how you view stuff. And if you have wanting clarity on a situation, you are about to be on the upright, because you're going to burst that bubble, that protective bubble that you put around yourself. And sometimes for some of you, that's going to be the rose-colored glasses. You're taking those off and seeing the situation for how it really is. And some of you are going to be seeking the truth. And you know the saying, whatever you give out, you get back, right? So whatever you're attracting, you're putting out, you're attracting back. So if you're wanting clarity and truth, some of you may find a truth that it may not leave a savory taste in your mouth. But you're going to be cutting out what is toxic. It's just a general. 2023 is about peace. All right. Before I get going on these right here, let me see what everybody said. Hi, Miss Misty. Hi, Miss Eva. You guys are welcome to say hi when you come on. This is going to be open discussion, so it's just kind of kickback. I will get through the cards here, and then I will be paying more attention. All right, so we've got beauty and truth right here. Here's beauty, and here's truth. Okay, so that's what I'm going to be focusing on. Now, this will not hit home for everybody, but I do see that for not just... See, the thing that is this is for the week ending the 15th, right? But this is not something you're going to stop at. Hi, Miss Samantha. This is not something you're just going to stop at just this week. It's not like one of those New Year's resolutions where you're like, okay, well, I'm going to gung ho, and then no. This is, you're going to take and completely work on this stuff, and that's the focus. Because why? Because you want blessings and peace, and it's just feeling more. People's hearts are opening, even though there is a lot of thorns on the outside in the external world, which that's not going to let up anytime soon. I'm going to tell you that right now. And you guys are actually are sitting here working on, I'll get those to a minute, working on a mindset change of how you view stuff, because instead of getting upset about everything, it's getting tougher. Tougher. A lot of people have been getting tough on themselves, really kind of reining up. Why? Because I know stuff's not going to get easier. So, you know, either you can go through 2023, and I know this is just a weekly reading, but this is going to be the theme. I tell you right now, this is definitely going to be the theme. You guys want your peace. And chaos and conflict, you're sick of it. Everybody's sick of it. So you're going to be working on refocusing, even though it's kind of like if there's a storm going on outside, but yet you're still getting stuff done inside. Okay, that's kind of how you look at yourself, your soul, because that's what's going on. No matter if there's a storm, no matter what kind of external is going on with people, the world, whatever's going on, right? Instead, it's about reacting in a different way, because now you're looking and externalizing, and you're going to be externalizing peace to others as well. Okay, even though there may be, like I said, granted, not everybody's going to be like that, but this is about you getting your peace big time. Some of you, this is the beauty and it's the truth, okay? Some of you, this is definitely going, male or females, this is definitely going to be hitting home. We've got the beauty card. This is actually, while you're getting this peace, while you're working on this peace, or it's going to come to you like, why have I had so much conflict about this? Why have I sit here and beat myself up, like, you know, metaphorically? It's almost like I'm seeing somebody standing in a mirror. And I see this a lot with females. Now, guys do this once in a while, too. When I'm doing readings and stuff, I can tell what's kind of going on, because I will see this card in my head. And then I'll see him standing in front of a mirror. And if you can't say, I'm beautiful, and it's not an arrogance thing, not even close. If you can't, you know, if you're sitting there going, I'm beautiful, please. That's not what I'm talking about. Y'all know what I'm talking about here. Beautiful. Beautiful is what you are externalizing to other people. It is what you're feeling about inside about yourself. It's being good with yourself, right? But able to share with others around you as well. And I'm not talking about just your materialistic goods. It's actually a lot of you opening up. Well, what I keep seeing is somebody standing literally in front of a mirror. Some are literally standing in front of a mirror evaluating their lives, whatever that means. Some of you, I'm actually seeing somebody standing in front of the mirror, and they can't yet. In February, you'll be able to. There is nothing wrong with standing in front of a mirror and saying, I'm handsome or I'm beautiful. There's nothing wrong with it. What I keep seeing is somebody getting ready to say that, and then they start crying. Yeah, crying happens. Or they just can't, they can't do it. They can't even look at themselves. So like, whatever. And then they get angry. Anger mask is masking another emotion, which is going to be sadness. That's what it is. Tears. Okay, so anyway, in February, if you are working on something like this, okay, where you're going to believe it as the truth. And some of you, the message here is that a truth will be revealed that, okay, I get it. All right, with the beauty card right there is talking about self-care. All right, the truth card right there is something, and you're going to see the truth in a situation. So this one right here especially, now I am picking up on female for this message right here. You will be able to overcome, and it's actually going to be at the end of January. And I know this is a weekly reading, but this is what I'm getting because it's going to be on your mind. Maybe you're standing in front of a mirror and saying this and you just can't get it out because somebody has put it in your head. And I'm not being cruel here, but you allowed them to, you're still allowing them to have control over you by sitting here not appreciating yourself and seeing yourself as a good human being. You know, if you can't see the beauty, you see the beauty in everything else. So what's why you look at the beauty within yourself as well. There's the balance right there, right? So this would be somebody who's still working on balance within 2023. But you're going to be standing here in February. You'll be able to, the truth, that it's going to, a realization is going to come to you. And that realization is, you know what? I am beautiful. So that is definitely going to hit a female. That one was a big one. Probably light haired spectrum. The only reason I'm laughing, oh God, I'll tell you a minute. With the beauty card, do you see how she's sitting right here? Okay, do you see how she kind of has little sides right there? Okay, the reason I'm laughing is because I actually went to the doctor and got on the scale and I said, oh, there's Christmas. 5 more pounds. It's okay. You chunk up during the winter and usually lose it during the spring. Okay. Well, here's the thing is that's another thing. You're going to stop tearing yourself apart. This is going to be for somebody. And I do understand being on the heavier spectrum, not right now, but if it has been something like that in the past, I have been. So I do know what this is about. But if you've got a spectrum like that, where it's almost like somebody put it in your head, where they kind of broke, they were trying to break you down. That's what it was about. They were trying to break you down because it made them feel better. And I, you know what? There's been a lot. I don't use the word narcissistic very often, but it's been coming up more and more. I think a lot of people are cutting people like that out of their lives. Whoever this was somebody who actually was talking to you like that to the point that you couldn't even look in the mirror. I think you're going to be cutting out the BS within your own mind and figuring and seeing this person for who they are. You may not be with this person, but the scars they left verbally is pretty deep. Okay, so I do see you overcoming this. It's going to be a journey. I think I've already seen, that's what I'm seeing is you've already been working on it for a little bit. Not just a little bit, but what I mean, okay, yeah, a little bit. So you do it for a little bit and then you'd stop. Then a little bit. Okay. 2023, I don't think you're going to be doing that. I think you're finally going to see the truth to yourself. You know what? Hey, I am worth this. Okay? And if this is, you know, that's, I was picking up on a female, but if you're just listening to that and that sounds like you as well, I mean, a lot of people, there, you have to think about it. There's lots of stuff that happens in life and it sticks with you, right? Sometimes you don't even realize that that's how you're thinking about stuff. Okay, I think a lot of people are coming within realization because they want that peace. And some may be feeling like they have a piece missing of them. I think you're going to come to a conclusion on this. Now, the reason this is showing up right now is especially this next week, it is going to be sticking in the head. A lot of the stuff is going to be mulling around different people's minds, big time. Hi, Susu. Okay, so let me see. What else do I get off that one? You know what? We just had the wolf moon. I wanted to do a reading on that, but I had to give my head a break. I'm going to use the moonology deck because we are still close enough to that moon. I feel it still. Woody. These cards right here are exactly backing up exactly what I just said. The message here is, okay, it's time to breathe out. You're going to take a breath. It's not going to be doing it for a little bit and then quitting and doing it. Okay. Right? This is time to breathe out, okay? That's the first message. Now, here's backing up what I was saying. This next week, what's going to be, and it may come as a, I get this. I understand this now. I'm going to start taking care of myself, you know? And I'm not saying you guys don't take care of yourself, but you guys know what I'm talking about, all right? You're going to see the truth of a situation is what you're going to do. It's a time for healing, All right. So this is closing up old doors. And I'm closing up old doors and I'm going to nail the damn thing shut because I'm done with it. Because I see, this is how I'm feeling. And somebody's on here. Because that's the truth of it. How dare they make me, and I think there was others around, feel like I just wasn't good enough. Okay, that's what I just heard. Okay, so time for healing. And you know what? And that's the thing too, is with the time for healing, you are going to get angry. It's going to happen. There's no doubt in my mind. You will get angry. But you know what? I'm not going to tell you not to, because you know what? You've got, yeah, that would make me angry too. All right? This is about somebody who's putting their foot down and no longer letting other people plow all over them and use them for a dust mop. That's what I'm getting. At one point, I think you'll be working on it this week, but I think it's really going to hit towards the end of January and the beginning of February. Truth about beauty. Confidence is your key. We've got Leo as well. Oh, we've got the strength of a lion, okay? All right, time for healing. Confidence is the key. Those are just messages. Let's see here. All right, I feel like taking those up. Those are done. You guys are welcome to say hi when you come on. This is being done live on Roosters Peacock on Facebook, and it's through my group Coffee Time Tarot on Facebook. So you guys are welcome to get on lives if you want. Just go ahead and like both of the pages, and I jump around, so... YouTubers, I will be jumping to YouTube as well. And I am getting ready to. Now, I would have started it with one of my first videos. I haven't done them for a long time, guys. This is Coffee Time Tarot. But here's the thing. I'm getting ready back to the self-sufficiency videos. All right. I just couldn't get to what I needed today. But the first one is about storage and storing stuff up. Okay. So it will be live. And I'll let you guys know, because I'm going to be jumping on those, because everybody, financially, I don't care who you are, it's time to make sure you have some stuff stored up for yourselves. And I'm not talking about buying everything out on the shelves. But I am going to give you guys some tips and tricks. So if you guys are not on my Roosters Peacock Tarot YouTube, I'm probably going to just turn that into Roosters Peacock here pretty soon, because I'm going to make sure I start doing my videos to show you guys how to, you know, even down to gardening, all kinds of stuff. I'm going to be hitting it hard because for everybody's, it's the financial pinch, and it's not going to get any easier this year. I'm going to tell you that right now. So there's your hint right there. But anyway, I'll start doing stuff to help you guys figure, you know, because it is a, well, I'll just do videos and you guys can join me and we'll talk all about it. I'm an herbalist and aromatherapist. So I will be giving you hints and tricks on different stuff you can make as well, especially around like antivirals and stuff like this, okay? All right. Next, travel. Nice. Travel. Forgiveness. Well-being. All right. So instantly when I got that message, this is going to be hitting home. Some of you, actually, I'm going to read the first way I see it. There's actually going to be literally traveling. There's going to be some kind of trip that may be going on. And it's within that trip. See, it could be for business. I'm not sure exactly. This is just general, but it's literally a trip that you're taking. And, it's kind of like almost getting in touch back with yourself. It's kind of like, do you see all the butterflies? It's releasing. And this one has the birds. Now, to me, the birds, especially for those who have like PTSD and stuff like that, the birds, when they're sitting here and they're on the, what are they called? Pieces of cloth, and they're hanging off almost like kites, and they're flying away. And you see somebody that has a tattoo that has it broken or something. That's them releasing. Okay. So I think this is whatever this is about. I'm not saying that's exactly but that's what I'm seeing in my head. With the birds right here, whatever it is, you're letting it go. Okay, but this is on this trip. It's kind of like you come back in touch with yourself. And it's talking about well-being. And in this one right here, we have the butterflies right here. So you may just be on a business trip or something like that. Who knows? You know, like I said, just a general. And you literally are taking and getting back in touch with yourself. A lot of people are going to be doing this January. Now, that's what I thought. Okay, reminder. If you guys watched all the ones I did for December and all January's monthly readings for each zodiac sign, Do you guys remember that most of the turmoil and the chaos and the... Some of you, it's going to be chaos, but it's all how you deal with it. It is stemming from around the 9th until, I think it was till the 18th. It was not every single sign was on the exact same dates, but it kept popping back up. I'm telling you, it may be a rough, bumpy little hot one, but I think it's going to open people's eyes and they're going to still be seeking their peace. All right. So if you haven't watched yours for January 2023, your zodiac sign one, and you guys can cross watch others as well. I've already got them up on YouTube and I already have them on Facebook as well on Roosters Peacock. So if you guys haven't watched them, I did pick up on dates. I mean, most every single zodiac sign, there was something going on around those times. All right. But I mean, it's all how you look at it. I think in the long run, it's about how people are going to be. It's just like with this one right here. They're out on a trip. This is the first way I'm seeing it. They're out on a trip and they're literally, it's just each one of these, their lights are shining. It's no longer letting people dim you down or thoughts dim you down or your past dim you down. It's actually working on peace. And even if you have to let something go. No, Miss Dee Dee, you don't hide. No, no. No, I didn't tell you guys those dates to hide. No, I'm just saying that, I mean, just looking at the cards right here, from what I'm seeing, it's like mind over matter. There may be stuff that goes on, but you're still going to be working on your well-being and your peace and, you know, it's releasing. It's kind of like a mindset for a lot of people. It's just no longer just sitting there tied up in knots, and I'm seeing the tied up in knots. Okay? It's all about doing, you know, putting it in your mind and looking at it in a different way. That's what it is. Yep. So, yeah, don't be hiding. Oh, my Lord. I can't blame you. Some days I do want to hide, too. But, it's just, I mean, you do have your off days and stuff, but you guys get the gist of it. Dee Dee. All right. So, with the travel, like I said, you could be out on a trip. Some of you may actually be taking a trip, and we're talking like it's business or it's just, I don't know what it's for. Like I said, just general. But this one right here is travel, and it's showing me forgiveness and well-being. So this message right here will probably be only, I'm going to read it two different ways, and then I'll be taking this one up. Okay? I mean, that's just a cut and dry right there. It's just kind of getting in touch with self, and that's where the true beauty, you know, the truth is coming in touch with yourself, whether you're male or female. No matter what's going on the external. Okay, so yep. Okay, so the other way I'm seeing this right here, we've got travel, forgiveness, and well-being. This one right here, this is literally like travel, okay? But it's not like the vehicle travel. This is traveling on, right? It's traveling. It's moving away from the past. You may even have to forgive someone or forgive yourself. The reason I'm saying this is because I'm picking up that, yeah, you may have to forgive yourself for how somebody else treated you. I heard that one. That's not going to hit home with everybody. Others of you, if you've got to forgive yourself or someone else, that's what it's about. Because you're focusing on your well-being. Because you don't want to, whoever this is, you're traveling on from it. The past is the past. The past was the past 1 second ago. Okay? It's kind of like however you perceive that, but you're leaving it behind. And some of you, it's about forgiveness of how hard you are on yourselves. Others of you, it could be literally, you know, maybe you said something this last, you know, it is Sunday, the 8th right now. And this is for Sunday ending on the 15th. Perhaps there's something that ends up being said. Perhaps you need to ask forgiveness for somebody or vice versa. All right. But in the end, it's just maintaining the balance. It's just hiccup. If something like that happens, that's what I hear. It's just a hiccup. But some of you are literally just going like this and moving on. Thoughts or physically, okay? You're just leaving it behind. Yep, stale and stagnant for too long. That's what I get. Not going to do it no more. Okay, wood. Yep, I believe. Dee Dee. I'm hiding out until the 21st. That's funny. Because you know what? I've had days like that. I've like... Okay, I can feel something coming. I'm going to hide for the next 2 weeks. But, you know, that's not, you can't really do that. I mean, if you can do that, great, but not really. All right. What cards for the travel card? Forgiveness and well-being. right. Do you remember what I said? Like I said, this is for the week ending on Sunday the 15th, right? Oh, my Lord. Okay, moderators. Miss Misty. Okay, do not, whatever you guys do, you guys are watching this live right now, do not, somebody put their Cash App up there, do not respond to them. They're after your money, and they better get the hell off my page. I tell you what, people like that, yeah, I will lose my temper on crap like that, because that is just horrendous, stealing people's money, and people don't have enough of it these days anyway. Shady people need to get gone. Give me just a second, because I have to revamp this real quick, and then I can get right back into it. But I tell you what, they're like gestational worms. They're just, they suck the life out of you. They're ridiculous. Oh, they make me so irritated. Sorry, but I'm done with it. They're going to be everywhere. They're everywhere. They call you guys all the time on the phone, those scammer spammers. But I tell you what, it's when they get people. That's what irritates me. Okay, anyway. Balance, Barda. Peace, Barda. Yeah. Okay, so anyway, let's get back to this one. On the travel, forgiveness, and well-being right here, the Moonology cards I got is the first one is it's time to release negativity. It's showing me Scorpio. I'm Scorpio. Is that for me? All right, so the next ones are emotions are running high. Now, as soon as I saw this right here, travel, forgiveness, and well-being. Okay, so this is four until the end of Sunday the 15th. So if there is something that comes down, there may be somebody who has to ask for forgiveness from somebody else or vice versa. And it may take, you know, take a leap of faith on them or on you, however this applies. If you do, and I'm seeing Taurus as well, but also it's somebody being bullheaded. That's what I got to. I instantly saw that one as well. Because it shows me emotions running high. And it's just time to just let it go. That's what I get. Okay, so whatever this is very temporary. This may even hit a Capricorn as well. Misunderstandings. I don't feel like reading them. These are just showing me zodiac signs. Virgo. Virgos, this next week will be realizing you are good enough. Feels right. Zodiac sign Cancer. You and your loved ones are safe. Whatever situation is going on. This is two part. Taurus. Now, I don't always do this, but I feel like doing this. You guys, this is focus points for next week. Taurus, the first one right here is prosperity lies ahead, but your dreams need a practical plan. So don't just chuck it in the garbage can, but just kind of, you might have to tweak some stuff here and there. Sagittarius, you need to look at the bigger picture. Cancer, a personal issue reaches resolution. Feels right. Whoa, that was strange. Capricorn, an end of a tough cycle approaches. Don't ask me why I'm doing this. I'm just going with it. Feels right. I'm not even sure how that happened. Thank you. Yeah, they kind of hammered everybody, didn't they? I'll tell you what. Mm-mm, not nice. Okay, so anyway. Aries, a fiery climax approaches. I'm supposed to give these messages because this is talking about next week. Leo, don't let pride get in your way. And this has to do with the forgiveness, the well-being, and the travel. It's like somebody might have to travel or you might have to move on from this. Okay. And it says it's time to release negativity. Emotions are running high. Okay. And it's showing me, I'm looking at Taurus. Don't be bullheaded or somebody was bullheaded. So if you have a situation like this, it says don't let pride get in your way. It's talking about Leo. They're still going, huh, Misty? Dang, look at all of them disappearing. Okay. The message for Aquarius is show the world the real you. All right, and I'm instantly seeing the beauty card in my head and the truth. Really show them the real you, the true you. Pisces, balance and spirituality and practicality. Like I said, this is not usual, but it feels right. Where did it go? Okay, Sagittarius, look at the bigger picture. Luck is on your side. That is your message for this next week. Why does all these cards feel like popping out? Because the energy is gaining momentum. There is change coming, big time. Then she's not completely banned then. If she keeps popping on, because like I said, I don't, it's probably not even a she. Okay, but it's okay. People like that are just rude. If it keeps happening, then just let me know and I'll go in there real quick and I'll make sure she can't get any more. All right. And if you guys, Rooster's Peacock, if there's a Rooster's Peacock that shows up as an ad friend for some reason, I mean, I think it's because I've been online so much more. If anybody, see, and I think this is posted in another psychics group, so that might be why we're getting hammered. But here's the deal. It doesn't work on mine. All right. No, we don't play around with it. Because we're here to have a good time, kick back, relax, and coffee time, tear it, get the messages, and then just chit-chat for a while. We're not here to spam, scam, or be a sham. Okay. Okay, so for this one right here, travel, forgiveness, and well-being, like I said, it's moving on from something. So this is going to be one of the biggest highlights right here for this next week. Okay, these two. Travel, forgiveness, and well-being. Okay, that is like the theme for the week. Right there, okay? But the end result is here, and this is what I'm feeling on this, is happiness and justice. There will be balance coming back in. So if you have something that, whether it's emotionally within yourself that you're overcoming, and it kind of throws you off kilter for a hot minute, or it's literally, you know, you heard all the messages, which I've never done that one before, but it felt right. It was going to each zodiac sign. Now, if it didn't show a zodiac sign, it doesn't mean it's excluding you. It doesn't mean anything like that. It's just those are the messages that showed up. Okay. But the end result here is balance, justice card. That represents Libra, but it also, hi, Miss Cynthia. From Peru. Let me see. I don't have anything Peru. Okay. Okay, so anyway, we've got the balance card here, which is the justice card, which also represents Libra. This one also reminds me of the justice card and the tarot as well. So I'm seeing Libra. This is definitely going to hit home with some Libras, and it's actually going to be hitting home with somebody with that, what do they call them? I'm listening to, you know, my boys used to call them a certain thing, and I was like, don't call them that. Okay, I'll just call it, okay, the politer term, because I think it's beautiful. I think red hair is beautiful. They call them gingers. Okay, so this is definitely going to hit somebody with ginger-colored hair. All right, balance will be restored. So if you have something that comes along, you're going to move on. Just move on from it. Don't sit there. The end result is happiness, okay? This, whatever this is, I keep hearing nothing will come of this situation, all right? As long as the messages that went out to the zodiac signs, as long as there's not bullheadedness in it, you know, to the point that you push it and it's not like the past. The message is, this is not like the past. It's a different situation, or you need to react in a different situation, or react in a different way. Okay, so anyway, happiness and justice is the results. Okay, so this is the week right here, literally. I mean, that's it. All right, feels right. Whoa. Okay, I'm going to leave those sit right here because they are supposed to go with these two right here. So I'm getting messages for the cards right here for happiness and justice. I mean, this is the end result. And I think these are showing up first the way they are. So that way, I mean, because each person might have something going on with their home. They might have something going on with their peace. Okay. Yep. I'm not drawing cards for people right now. It'll be at the very end, okay? Right now, we're just doing coffee time tarot. And then I will pull one card at the end. Okay, so anyway, we've got confidence is your key. We've got communication is the key. All right. So over happiness and justice right here, it's showing me confidence is the key. All right, do not, okay, right now, guys, sorry, I'm going to pause this for a hot minute. Misty, do not delete them. Don't delete them next time. Let me have them. Because if they keep popping on, they're not completely deleted. So the next one that pops on, let me get them. People like that. Okay, so anyway, under happiness here, confidence is your key. In order to get this balance and to get this happiness within yourself, confidence is the key, okay? Anybody who's popping on here, cards will be at the end, and I will pull one card, and I'll let you guys know when we're doing this. Right now, we're doing Coffee Time Tarot, which is the general messages, and at the end, that's when I'll go ahead and it's open discussion. Okay, so anyway, confidence is your key. Could represent Leo. Then we have communication is the key. Could be Gemini. Okay, could be hitting home with Gemini or involve Gemini. Around your happiness and justice, the question here is, people will be thinking this over here too, okay? What do you need to release? Others of you that's been sitting back and you know you need to take action on a situation, this is about people who are cutting stuff out. Either sometimes it's your own behavior to where how you react, or it's actually cutting situations that are toxicity to you or make you feel inferior. That's what I get. And not saying that, you know, we're almighty and all that. That's not what I'm getting. Hi, Miss Dana. We have, it's time to take action. And I hear an Aries season. So what I get from this one right here, this is going to hit home with somebody who's on here. The message here, and I just got through saying, what do you need to release? During Aries season, because it's almost like they've got a plan, and it's surrounded around your justice and your happiness, and I do think for this situation right here, you're actually going to be cut and dry. You're going to cut the cord, or whatever it is. It's whoever, okay? So your message is, the answer is going to be, in Aries season, that's when you're going to be doing it. That's not very far off at all. Yep. What do you need to release? It's still coming to that judgment right there, but you're going to bring balance. Balance is coming back in because you want your happiness. Got it. Do not answer them. Don't answer them. I got you. Give me just a second. I got you. Give me a minute, guys. I got to go do cleanup. Clean up in aisle 4. Swear to God. Give me just a second. Shady people. Shady. Yeah, no. Don't answer any of those cash apps. Nothing like that. Mm-mm. You don't do this on my page. Nope. Scammers, spammers, and overall fools looking to hurt people, don't even come on my page. There we go. See ya. Bye-bye. Next. What else we got? Tell Mary. Oh, I've already got her. Yeah, I was blocking her. It's kind of rude because it does take, I can pick up. I've been reading for over 28 years now, so I can pick up right where I was before. But yeah, we actually had some that took and they thought they were helping me, which you guys noticed, I did add my P.O. box. I did get a P.O. box. So you guys were talking about wanting to send me letters. You were wanting to send me cards and such. And then I was looking for seeds. I have a P.O. box, so we can bypass all these scammers, spammers, and obliterated fools, okay? So that is on Rooster's Peacock, and it's attached to this video, so that is my legit P.O. box. Yeah, people are just shammy. It's okay. Catch them again. All right, so anyway, with this one right here, it's talking about what do you need to release. It's time to take action. It could be about Aries, but I really think it's about Aries season when you're going to be really putting this into action. I don't even think you're really on the fence about this, but what I do feel is a simple fact that you've been mulling it over, and it's been the beauty card and the truth. The truth is going to hit you, and it's almost going to smack you in the face, and it has to do with another person because actually I am seeing the romance deck in my head. And yes, I am picking up on somebody on here. Yep, Exactly. That is exactly what's going on here. Okay. But you will be taking action. If you haven't had this conversation, it's showing me girl talk. Okay. So it's like you're talking with somebody else about this. Anyway, and you, whatever this was about, whether it's been, whatever it was very oppressing, but it also was like you weren't even showing your real self to everybody else. We've got the coffee cup here. Okay. So there's going to be conversing. And I don't think this necessarily, this is like the situation. So it could be, you could be cut and dry in this crap and have it done by Aries season. Okay, however it applies, you already know kind of what you want to do, but you're back and forth on it because it's about the beauty card and the truth. It's going to hit you, it's going to smack you, and you're going to be like, oh, this is the truth. What? Why did I let them make me feel like this? Why did, you're going to get mad. There are people that are going to be losing their I do cuss, what's the polite word? They're crap, okay? There are going to be people who's going to be losing their crap, and they're not going to take any more crap. And they're going to have like an aha moment, like, oh man, you know what? This is, I'm working on me. I want balance in my life, okay? And this is something you thought about back in Libra season. I am picking up on somebody on here. This one right here, meeting and conversing, savoring the moment, and it's talking about friendship. So it's like you're hanging out with some friends. I'm picking up on somebody on here, so this is not going to hit everybody else. And it's kind of like you're getting together and you're talking to somebody about this, and it kind of makes you feel better. You know, like when you talk to your best friend or whatever, you know, you're ascending, you're getting over it, you're overcoming these obstacles, which some of them, it's not just mental obstacles. There's actually physical ones. You had to get balance within prosperity, which is your finances as well. All right. Something about household. So most likely moving something to do with the household. Okay. There had to be balance within the household. Okay. So this one right here is passion, but this one to me, this is like conversing. You're getting together, talking to somebody about this. And this is not about passion. It's about having fun. It's kind of like where she's sitting here. Let's see. Like this one right here, well-being, you know, just really, and this is something that you haven't been able to do for a long time, or it's something where you didn't, when you were out and about around people, you weren't feeling that great about yourself, and I'm not being rude, but it's just you couldn't enjoy it. It wasn't the same, okay? This time you're going to notice that you're going to feel more lighthearted about it, and Aries season is sticking out in my head big time, okay? Spring is definitely going to start feeling quite springy for you is what I feel. Okay, you're sitting here talking. What are you talking? See, sometimes people bottle up stuff and they don't talk about it. And sometimes there's certain people you can talk about everything. And then others, it's people that, you know, like nobody understands me, this and that. That's what this is going on here. What you're talking to, literally, see, here's girl talk. Okay, so you're sitting here literally just getting together with a friend, somebody who's trusted, and you're going ahead and talking this about. Talking this out, and this is talking about being stabbed in the back. Now, if this actually has to do with the friendship or somebody stabbed you in the back, then apply it how you will, but this is definitely going to hit home. Whatever it did literally took and disrupted how you thought about your life in general, and it kind of put what I'm seeing is a candle, and I'm seeing, you know, those where they put the candles out. Okay, well, you're coming out of this. This is not something you're going to be hanging on to. You're just going to let it, you're going to end up letting it go and not even have a realization you're doing it, because happiness is creeping in and balance, because there's balance coming back into the life. Well, hi, hammer, I'm nail. What in the world, Samantha? What does that mean? You're silly. Okay, so anyway, confidence is the key. Communication is the key. It's showing me the zodiac signs Leo and Gemini, okay? And it says, what do you need to release? It's time to take action, Aries, okay? So that is the messages on those. Oh, let's see here. Samantha. You're goofy. All right. Over these cards right here, I'm just supposed to pull some more. All right, that's why. Yep. Did I not just get through saying people, especially the last Coffee Time Tarot, if you did not watch that one, hit the nail on the head. I just went through the situation. Oh, really? I was trying to figure out what was high hammer, I'm nail. She says hit the nail on the head. I just went through that situation this past week. Okay. I wasn't sure what you were doing. Okay, so along with the confidence is the key to success, new moon in Leo, communication is the key, Gemini, what do you need to release? It's time to take action. Okay, no more sitting on the fence. This is what it's about. Why? Because you're cultivating your prosperity. This is talking about this next week, but it is going to span into 2023, not just next week. This is going to be the theme, peace. People are seeking their peace in 2023. And they are cutting people, places, and things out of their life that is toxic to them. Whether it is mentally toxic to them, or they're just, I mean, we can get, I'm not even going to go a whole bunch. I just said, heard, stop right there, because I'm pretty blunt. Okay, so cultivating prosperity. The abundance of the universe is pouring into my life. Okay, so this is something that, and it's showing me with the justice right here, which also represents Libra. I keep looking at Libra season of last year. Okay, this was on your mind already. You might have already started planting the seeds of changing how you view stuff back in October. Okay, part of October towards the, that's what I'm getting. Yep. So some of you, if you worked really hard on it, and it's just slowly growing, okay? And it's talking about having patience with yourself while you're doing this. And you know what? If you're in a household and you're not the only person in the household, guaranteed, if other people are working on themselves as well, they're not perfect either. So here's the thing, is they're cultivating too. All right, the abundance of the universe is pouring into my life. You're starting to sit back in this week, really looking back, it's kind of trickling in. And I think I've already said this, in January, it's going to start trickling in. So if this has to do with your coins, it's what have you worked really hard on, focused on a lot, whether it's your emotions or I think it's all around. It's not just one thing. Back in October, I mean, that's standing out big time. Matter of fact, you didn't have a lot of confidence in it at first. It's starting to come in a little bit. So if it was about, I'm seeing coins for some of you. Others of you, it has to do with yourself. It's showing me flowers. Okay, it's really where you're blooming as with yourself. You're producing. That didn't sound good. You're really producing results within self. Okay, that's what I'm getting. It's slow. So do have patience with yourself if you've been working on yourself. Others of you who have been working on your prosperity. And all around, it's about gaining balance and happiness and peace. That's the big thing right there. Yep. And October of 2022 is standing out. Okay, some of you are manifesting your dreams. Some of you have already worked on this. You've been working on it. And my dreams are coming true. Okay, so you're starting to see the results. It's kind of like the harvest. All right, the cornucopia. You're going to have more than plenty. That's what I'm getting. All right, you're actually sitting back. And it's not all about materialistic, but you have to have that to live. So that, I mean, it's like there's more balance. So do remember, if there's a little bit of a hiccup, and like I said, if you guys did not watch January's 2023 for each zodiac sign, I do have those up, and it did show from like the 9th until I think it was the 19th. I mean, I've done so many readings, but there was a lot of different stuff that was going on that is going to make people question it, all right? But here's the thing is, it's just a hiccup. Whatever it is, it's a hiccup. Unless you have not taken and turned in the direction that you need to be in your life. And I'm telling you what, then a tower could come down. It's those who have ignored stuff and turned their back on it and thought, oh, I'll get around to it to another day because, you know, I don't want to deal with it. It could be it's a toxic person in your life. It could be a toxic situation. It could be what you're telling yourself. Whatever it is, it's don't procrastinate on it. All right. That's what I get. Okay. I think I'm going to be saying this a lot when I'm doing my readings. Don't hit the messenger. Simplify your life. Clean it up. That's what I get. Some of you, I kept getting procrastination, toxicity. Okay, sometimes that's like physically as well. All right? Sometimes you literally have to clean up your surroundings. Quit putting it off because it may bite you in the butt. And the reason I'm saying that is for some, if there's things you need to get cleaned up, there could be something going on that you cannot see right then and there unless you move stuff. All right. For some of I'm not trying to freak people out, but the weather's going to be changing here pretty soon. And when it gets warm inside, this is going to hit home with somebody. It is. Or I wouldn't even be getting it because I've actually gone through the black mold thing. And let me tell you what, whatever it is you're putting off, if it got damp and wet or whatever, you need to get to it now. Okay. But it says simplifying your life. So you're simplifying, literally getting rid of stuff, okay? And this showed up on the last reading as well. simplifying your life, an example is, you know what, maybe you just want to get it out and you want to throw it away. Okay, well, financially, you're going to be pinched a little bit, and why not make some money back off of what you've got? I mean, or donate it or something, you know? You guys watch the other one, you understand, because usually it's like, okay, I'm tired of looking at this. I'm throwing it away. It's in my way. All right, so simplifying life, and maybe somebody else could use it, or, you know, however it applies. Yep, yep. What am I supposed to look at here? Okay, I get it. Okay, this is going to hit home with probably just one here, maybe two. Okay, on here is a box of, it's a heart box where chocolates were in, right? So literally, what I picked up on that, I was like, what is Valentine's Day got to do with it? If you have been thinking about, oh, I need to do this yard sale, I need to do this and that, for whatever reason, it's going to be around Valentine's Day. It's sticking out. I mean, and for some of you, I was sitting here getting that, you know, it could be a real problem. Your message may be, don't wait until Valentine's Day to get around to this because you need to take care of it now. All right, so I would just check, move stuff. That's what I would do. That's not going to hit home with everybody, but whatever it is, what I'm picking up on, it could be a basement. I don't know what it is, but it got damp. All right, so if you had some kind of flooding or something and you're sitting here watching this, and even though, oh, it's cold. No. There's something going on is what I get. And the color I'm seeing is white, so the room's white. All right, so you might want to check that out and not wait until the weather gets a little bit better. That's something you've been saying for a while. Don't do it. Don't do it. It's going to cause some problems. Go down there, move stuff around. It literally wouldn't take that long. Just get it taken. I'm seeing water damage, but it's not just water damage. It's growing. That's what I get. Okay, anyway, back to it. So I'm going to pull these up right here. Now, I'm not to these yet. I'm supposed to leave them right there. I'm going to leave them. Oh, what was that? Okay, now this one was when I went to go put those back, I instantly was attracted to this one. I was like, oh, no. Well, yeah. Okay, the message here is you're very close to achieving your goal. Okay, so sometimes it just, and the message is don't let the past, two messages, don't let the past hold you back. And here's Libra again. For some of you, whatever you started in Libra season, for whatever you started in Libra season or whatever you've been working to bring balance in, is the end result is a win-win outcome is the forecast, all right? And happiness, that's what I'm getting. So balance is coming, but it's not something that's laid in your lap. This is something you actively worked for. Okay, let's see how. No, I don't feel like taking those up. Okay, so the next focus we have right here is home and peace. All right? Home and peace. Some of you may actively be working on bringing peace back into your home. Others of you may not be feeling so peaceful because I keep seeing the clean it up card, the one I just showed you where, you know, and this is going to hit home with somebody who had some water damage. I don't know why you're picking up on my, I'm picking up on you. Because I'm telling you, you need to look down there. You need to, because it's going to be a lot worse. And I think it has to do with your health, too. It's going to cause health issues. So I'm guessing it's black mold or something like that. And that's what it feels like. Because somebody keeps saying, oh, it's too cold for it to happen. No, it's not. It's already actively going. Okay, so anyway, the home. So anyway, you're working on your peace within your home, however that applies to you. Okay, this is... Like I said, for the week ending the 15th of January, next Sunday, working on inner peace. Yeah, some of you are literally taking and cleaning your homes out. This is not just, you know, and that's true. If you have you guys ever, hi, Miss Jeanette. Let me get a drink. Have you ever thought about this? A lot of people have not thought about it like this. And when I actually use it sometimes when I'm giving readings, so, you know, people are like, I never thought of it that way. A lot of people are going to be focusing on, because they're like, I want the negative energy out of here. I want to, you know, maybe I need to get some sage. Maybe I need to do this and that. A sage is great. So is Palo Santo. But here's the thing. If you don't clean your house, all that residual energy is sitting in there. So imagine this. Just an example. Here's the home, right? And you want your peace. And maybe you feel like your light's kind of been dulled a little bit. Or you feel just kind of like there's negative energy going on. Here's a way to look at it. If you're sitting in a home where you have not done your dusting, you haven't done your cleaning for a while, and maybe perhaps Uncle Jim Bob or whoever it was came in and they were one of the most negative people and you could just feel them sitting in that house. It's just like, it just won't go away. And then you have somebody else. Maybe it was back in the summer that came in and perhaps, I don't know, whoever it was. Maybe somebody was shady. They came in and it's just like, that builds up. You know why? Here's part of it. It's not just the energy. And I'm not being gross here. You think about this. Think about it. If you've been, I think the reason I'm saying this, if you haven't cleaned your house and you've had it on your mind and you're tired of the negative energy, you need to do it. Why? Okay, so every day, how many skin cells does a human lose? How many pieces of hair do you lose? You see where this is going? So somebody been in your home and you just can't seem to shake the negative thoughts and feels on it and just feels almost like that person's there or just that same negative. It's because there's part... They're there. It could be in dust. It can be, I mean, in your dust. It could be in your dust. And if you haven't vacuumed, cleaned, moved stuff, cleaned it, washed stuff down, they're not just their residual energy. Their physical energy is there too. Biologically, right? You lose hair. You lose skin cells. Think this out. So going through running sage and stuff like that is good, but it's not going to fix everything if you do not clean out your home. It's like a breath of fresh air when you do it. So a lot of people are like, I never thought of it. I said, you know what? I never used to. And then I got to where I had a lot of time on my hands and I thought, wait a minute. I keep feeling this and that. And how many skin cells do you lose a day? There's your answer right there. So if you want to get people out of your life that you just can't seem to shake them, probably because there's actually biologically they're there. So, if you've been putting this off and you want this peace and you want to be able to radiate and shine within self, but you have this nagging feeling of this person still being around, clean your home up. Then run your sage through. Then, you know, along with your Palo Santo, open up the door, take yourself a natural broom, and after you're completely done cleaning everything top to bottom, then you open up the door and you sweep them out. Sweep out the energy. Then you go through and you sage it again. You want to talk about some peace, try it. Okay. Stalkers, oh man, I tell you what, I've had a few of those in my day. I do not, I feel sorry for you on that one. Yeah, definitely clean them out. Yep. Okay, so that's what I get off that one, peace and home. I mean, really what I just told you, for some reason, that's going to hit home big time with somebody. That big time. Yeah, I'm supposed to leave it. All right, I'm going to get, let me pull at least one or two. But it's going to lead to balance feeling and justice. Some of you, the word is justice. Justice will be served and it's going to bring happiness. But for others of you, it's balance is coming back and it's going to bring that happiness and it's going to bring peace within the home is what I'm getting. But this is showing me zodiac sign Cancer, which the last moon we had, I believe, was in Cancer. Okay. Personal issue reaches resolution. Okay. Next message. Have faith in your dreams. And it's talking about home, the peace, happiness, and balance, justice. Others, it's work through your fears. That's it. Okay. And it's showing me zodiac sign Scorpio. It doesn't necessarily mean that it has to just do with Scorpio. It's just, I just read what's on there because it felt right. Okay, so anyway, home and peace. I don't fit down. That's done. Done. Oh, you know what? I keep hearing karma. Karma. So I'm going to pull a couple karma cards about peace in the home. Maybe. Oh. Okay, for some of you, this could be about, and this is talking about happiness and balance, justice coming back, you know, balance coming in. For some of you, it's justice. Peace in the home, is that's what your end goal is here, right? And for some of you, it's home is where the heart is. Okay, so some of you, why are you feeling like this and why are you still bouncing back and forth a little bit? I mean, life's balance. You just got to, you know, you're still, you're not always going to be even keeled all the time. But if you do have a hiccup through this week, why does it feel like this? But yet, I mean, your happiness, justice, balance, I mean, you can feel it coming back in. But there may be a moment where it's just kind of like, oh, it could be you and somebody, it's showing me forgiveness. And then you're going to have to move on from this, or you have to move on from the situation. And then we've got well-being. Okay, with this one right here, some of you, the reason it's like that is because we've got the karma card and it says your destiny, because this is the path that you were supposed to be on. And so if you just recently went through what I would call the tower moment, especially in 2022, the last half of it, that's what I get right there. You're on your destiny path, okay? And you're actively choosing. You're choosing your happiness. You're choosing your peace. You're choosing your balance. And this is not something that's laid in your lap. This is something you worked on. And for some of you, the message is, home may not have felt like home, but you're going to take your home back. Whatever that means. It says, and for others of you, the message of it's saying your career. Okay, you're going to have, there's balance coming back in. Maybe it was a hiccup. Maybe you were looking for work. Whatever it's about, it's talking, these are just message cards. Others of you, the next message is where you're going. See, I'm looking up here at the top. Where you're going. You know where you're going now. You know a direction now because you're able to walk away from the past and thoughts and how it made you feel. Whatie, buddy. Okay, and for under peace right here, we've got learn or teach. Okay, some of you may have learned a lesson. Or some of you, hi, buddy. Or some of you may be taking, and this is, take it with a grain of salt, teaching someone a lesson, okay? But you're going to get your peace. That's what I'm going to get my peace. Balance is coming back in, and that's what I'm hearing. So this is like an agitation. It's a message I'm picking up on. Others of you, it's about growing and expanding how you think about stuff. You're no longer sitting here thinking like back in the last half of December, glass half full, glass half empty. The color black, the color white, you're now looking in color. Okay, you're seeing all the colors. Not just, you know, one or the other. Nothing in between. Minds are opening up. Yeah, okay, what'd I say? Growing and expanding. Others of you, it's talking about, for some of you, there may actually be, it's talking about the home growing and expanding. There may be people coming into your home, or you may be moving to another home to where you're, I mean, because you need more. You need more room. However it applies to you, this is just general. I don't feel like going any deeper. Not on those. Out they go. Yeah, man, I tell you what. All right, Sue. See, these are all, and then I'll do a quick recap on these. Okay, so now we're going to move on to the blessings. And what I'm hearing is, it's the blessings, not the lessons. All right, you're not focused on the lessons so much. You're starting to focus more on the blessings. Yep. This message is definitely going to be hitting home. Whatever this was not just around, it was around the full moon, which would have been the wolf moon. Okay, so yeah, this is a reading until the 15th. You know, from starting from Monday tomorrow. Like I said, this is tomorrow the 9th until the 15th. But this was something that you had been focusing on. Perhaps you actually enjoy being out in front of the moon. What? Oh, please hold. Oh. Okay. I'm going to try to delete them because as the moderators do it, make sure you push block and ban. If you can't block and ban them, just say something to me and then I'll block and ban them. Okay. If not, they're just going to keep coming back in. I'll tell you what. It's okay. Get everywhere. So anyway, we've got the blessings. Focus on the blessings, not the lessons anymore, because lessons have been learned. That's what I get. And so whatever this was, it was around the moon. So if you've had a situation around the wolf moon, okay, so this weekend, this is being done on Sunday the 8th, something around this weekend that kind of made you feel tense, okay, or there was something going on. Just think of the wolf moon. It says, bring love into the situation. Okay, so if you had something that kind of, maybe it reared its ugly head, maybe there was a misunderstanding, maybe somebody wasn't thinking about you when they were spilling something out. Or vice versa, okay? Because I'm feeling that some of you guys also did this as well. bring love. And the message is for the week ending in the 15th. This is not quite done. And you do need to bring love into the situation. And it could involve an Aquarius person. Okay? Or it could be Aquarius season. I think it's an Aquarius person. Or somebody who has... And see, Aquarius is... I keep one... You know what? What's sticking out in my head? I'm Scorpio. So what I keep hearing is Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. So it's probably one of those. But anyway, you're focusing on the blessings, not the lessons. Okay? Really just open to be, just continue. You've been working really hard on your happiness, the balance, your home, and your peace. Okay? Just all of it. And your well-being. Letting things go. Moving on from stuff. So if you have like a little hiccup that comes up, focus on your blessings, not your lessons. All right? You learned it already. Let it go. That's what I hear. Just let it go. No, you're fine. I think you should be able to block them too. Like go in there to Rooster's Peacock, but... Hi, buddy. Hey. He's going to sing the song of his people. Okay, so anyway, let's see here. Now, Bubba. He'll get up underneath the bed and do that too. Okay, so over the bring love into the situations and blessings, I do feel like pulling tarot cards. Now, a lot of times I do pull tarot cards, but I was just, you know, didn't feel like it. But I do on this one, so let's see what pops up. Yep. Okay, this may actually have to do with, it could be about family, friends, or lovers, but I really think it's some kind of dynamics. It could be like between daughter and father, or it could be between lovers, okay? Why? Because I'm seeing the King and Queen of Pentacles here, and this is over, has to do with bring love into the situation. Whatever this is around the wolf moon, okay, you already got a taste of this, or it's something that's already reared its ugly head, but you're going to be focusing, and you need to focus on the week ending the 15th, all that week. You need, when this, it's going to come back up, you need to think of the blessings, not the lessons, okay, because you already learned lessons, or you're going to be sitting here, I thought they learned that, why didn't they figure that out, okay, it feels tense, okay, but here's the thing. There's a new beginning coming, and even though there's temporary restrictions, those are going to be lifting, okay? But it's going to feel like, literally, you're going to get your peace one way or the other. But just don't go back into the mindset of, because I'm feeling kind of like this, like enough. Like somebody's just annoying the heck out of you, and you've had enough. All right, I think you're going to, if you can keep the balance within it, we've got the Queen of Pentacles, and there's many meanings in here, but I'm not pulling them all out. This is just representing people involved, all right? And the Queen of Pentacles is somebody who's got their mind on their money and their money on their mind, okay? And they really do like the finer things in life, but they also are very smart in how they do stuff. As far as, I mean, nature, they like nature. I'm not supposed to go too far into it. They're focused on their prosperity. Coins is on their mind a lot. It's showing me Virgo, possibly. This one right here, we've got the Fool card. All right. Now, this is zero in the deck. So this is a brand new beginning. So the message here is only going to hit. I just picked up on a message for somebody on here. If this so far has sounded like you, you may be getting ready to have to be wanting to take a leap of faith with somebody. And it may bring up emotions of, remember the lessons? Think of the blessings, not the lessons, because you already learned the lessons. Perhaps you're getting ready to expand as far as like not just dip your toe into the water with somebody else, but maybe you are. Whatever this is a big leap of faith here, okay? The Fool card here, it doesn't strike me as being somebody being foolish. This is zero. This is starting from scratch, okay? You already learned lessons. Now you're ready to receive the blessings. And it is showing me somebody. And it's showing me, I'll get more into that here in a minute. It's showing me the Eight of Swords here. Now, she's feeling blinded by a situation, okay? It's almost like somebody's jumping back in their head to the past. So if you feel like you're going to be like that, catch yourself. You've already learned the lessons. Focus on the blessings. Because this time around, that's not what it's about. If it is a situation where you're actually having to have being called to take a leap of faith with somebody else, which is somebody is like a perfect match. We got the Queen and the King of Pentacles. Both have their mind on their money and their money on their mind. But... this is two peas in a pod. And there's many meanings, but I don't feel, no. This time around, this person's very grounded and very mature. That's what I get. I didn't think it was going to go into the romantical, but we'll go ahead and pull that. Yep. The message is, if you're starting off in a new one, and it's like you have to take a leap of faith, but there has been, you know, it may make you feel trapped for a hot minute because you're reacting towards the past. This is only if you're starting off in a good one, and there's no way. I mean, you can't see anything that's wrong with it, really. But here's the thing. If you're used to a certain way, you may find, you may one way or the other find something wrong with somebody. If you were not treated right in the past. After a while, I mean, and it might give you it may take and make you feel like this, blinded by subject. You know what? It may make you feel like you need to step back to a past reaction. Focus on the blessings, not the lessons, because the lessons are already learned. That's the message. Whoever this is very grounded. This is a brand new beginning. Because why? This week you may be asked to take a risk, take a chance. Hand of cards. Yep. Not showing. I'm surprised the sunglasses haven't shown up. This is not going to hit home with everybody. Yeah, this may give you a hot moment tipping to the past is what it is. But you'll be able to grab yourself on this one. Because whatever this is two peas in a pod. What? What? Oh, my Lord. Two peas in a pod, right? That means you're pretty similar. It could be twin flame, soulmate, somebody who's very, very similar to you. We've got the mirror. You're mirroring each other. Okay? That's two peas in a pod. We've got the card seduction. Attraction. That's where I want to take it. I mean, seduction. I ain't going to take it any farther than that. Y'all can figure that stuff out. But here's the thing. What? You've been waiting for that message to come in. Somebody may actually be revealing that they love you, or you may finally get that message you've been waiting for. Whoever this is, you already know it's two peas in a pod. But you may be assuming, and do watch for that if you're in one of those situations where it seems like it was really good and everything, but maybe they get quiet for a little while, and then all of a sudden it's like, why? Oh my God, this must be done. Oh no. Eight of Swords. What am I supposed to do? Yep, hopeless, helpless. And then all of a sudden, here comes this. Somebody's going to take a risk. Somebody's going to take a chance. Been marrying each other. Maybe there was a misunderstanding. And all of a sudden, this message comes. And you were sitting here in the past for a hot minute. This is a brand new beginning. Someone expresses love, or they calls you through text message. It's phone calls, something along those lines. Somebody lets you know that they're thinking of you. We've got the seduction card, and I don't feel like reading off that. I mean, this is cut and dry. So don't let your brain, if you're used to a certain pattern, if you've actually got somebody in your life, this is two peas in a pod is what I'm picking up. This is not going to hit home with everybody, but definitely is going to hit home with some. Don't let your brain get all squirrely on it. Don't, because it's, don't react like you did before. It's a misunderstanding. So maybe that's where you need to forgive yourself. If you jump the gun and be like, oh my God. Or if it's the other person that they assumed. Okay. That's all I need. This is just general. But this is a brand new beginning. This is about a leap of faith. Okay. It's about needing to have faith and focusing on your blessings, not your lessons, because you already learned them. You don't live there anymore. That's just overall, okay? Bring love into the situation. Quit focusing on all the restrictions or what you think is restricted. Okay. The lessons, not the lessons. All right. Next card right here is we've got compassion. Okay. Now, this one was face down. So this could be about the situation, or this could be something that you're not saying out loud to somebody else, or something that you're sitting there thinking about while you're by yourself. You know, just something that you're not something that you're just going to expose to everybody. That felt right. Okay. Remember what I just said? I think this week, for not everybody, but for a lot. I just heard it's for a lot. Do you know when there's, like, I was just explaining that situation where it was like two peas in the pod. It's two people who were together. You know, this is not going to apply to everybody, but this is situations, whether it's family, friends, or lovers, okay? I think that there's going to be like a Loki effect this week. I'll show you, because we've got compassion and we've got nothing will come of this situation. This is general. This is all over the board. So do watch for misunderstandings. Don't let your brain, don't focus on the lessons of the past. You've already learned them. You're in the here and now. Focus on your blessings. So that way when there's something that's kind of like a Loki effect, that's what it feels like. There's a Loki effect. Focus on your home and your peace and your justice and your happiness. Get your balance. Keep it. Not just get it. Keep it. If somebody needs to say sorry, say sorry. Move on from it. Focus on your well-being and those that you care about. But do watch for the Loki effect. It feels correct. Because it says here, and I just picked, that's like the third one I picked up in my brain of it just being, it was a reaction like, oh my God, this is what's going on. Oh, I just can't do anything about it. But it was a new beginning. Totally not what they were thinking. Nothing will come of this situation. Have compassion. That is the message. Whatever life brings you this next week, it's got the Loki effect. And you guys know who Loki is. Nothing will come. That's it. I'm supposed to repeat it one more time. Nothing will come of this situation, no matter what it feels like or how it seems. It's not even veiled. It's Loki effect. It's like trickster. Plays tricks on your brain. Might make people kind of behave in a different way than they normally would. Or assume. Be careful of assuming. Focus on your blessings, not your lessons of the past. You already learned your lessons. Everybody just... Nothing will come of this situation, excuse me. That's what I keep getting. And remember, in your world, in your home, where you're working on your peace and your happiness, and a lot of you, it's not just you, and your justice, which is your balance, use compassion. Somebody, and that's a hint too, is also if somebody else kind of goes with the Loki effect and just starts, you know, showing the mirroring, that's not just for coupling there. That's not what I'm feeling. I mean, it felt like that for that. But for some of you, people are going to really be mirroring each other as far as they're, you know, one sitting here behaving one way, the other one instantly does it. This could be family, friends, lovers. Loki effect. Yep. Use compassion. Somebody may have to literally forgiveness. So do look for family, friends, lovers to... throughout the week, even could be yourself. If a situation comes up and it's very confusing, you're like, where in the hell did that come from? Just forgive and move on from it. If it's forgivable. I mean, if it's some crazy stuff, you guys know there's fine lines. But if it's just something where, you know, like that example where these two people, it's a misunderstanding because one's sitting here thinking, oh my God, you know, this is not going to work. Two peas in the pod. The truth of it is they have a new beginning. But she's over here for a hot minute feeling like she's being restricted and can't see everything for what it is. You see, you guys know what I'm talking about. Loki effect. Nothing will come of the situation. Nothing. Lord Almighty. Okay. What do you want? Okay. Oh, you know what? I keep wanting to say it. Focus on your blessings, not your lessons. That's what I get. Might be one of those sayings that while you're going through your week, I hope it sticks in your head because you're going to have to remember it a couple times this week, I think. And compassion. Use compassion, not assassin. Oh, yeah. There's all kinds of stuff you can put in your head so you don't lose your proverbial crap. Okay. Now, the last four here. Now, I'm not going to pull tons and tons because I already went into some of them. Some of you, I think this is telling me the area of life. You know, it could be around what people or what the focus is or, okay? For some of you, this is going to have to do with a committed relationship, all right? And this does feel like some kind of coupling. All right? So this could be affecting this week. That's what it feels like. For others of you, you may actually be feeling like opening up your heart some. Now, I'm going to read this two different ways. Okay? This right here, why are you feeling... Why? Okay, I'm going to read it this way. Two different ways. Let me go back. Commitment. Okay, we read all this right. Okay, so not the, just take out the Loki effect for a hot minute. Commitment. That's the message right here. This is what you need to be focusing on, even though there may be a confusing situation throughout your week. Okay, something that just kind of throws you off, like, where in the hell did that come from? Okay, commitment. Marriage, partnership, something that's kind of it's serious. Now, commitment can also be about business partnerships as well. However it applies. But this one, it's kind of like it affects your home. Just remember, if something happens, move on from it. Forgive. Focus on your well-being. Happiness, justice, balance. The home is where the heart is. That's where I get it. Peace. Okay, that's what you're to focus on. Others of you, if there is the Loki moment with the commitment, this is telling you. How do they put that? See sheet A. Okay, go back again. Remind yourselves, you know, happiness, justice, home, peace, well-being. Focus on it. If you have to forgive, somebody's got to say sorry. Somebody, and I'm seeing Taurus in my head. Do not be like the bull. Somebody has got to stop being bullheaded. That's what I'm getting. Don't be bullheaded. Forgive. Whatever this is, does not feel bad. Okay. This one right here, we've got the love card. This isn't telling self-love. And I just instantly heard there may be a hiccup, something that happens to where you have a hot minute where it's interrupting your inner peace you've been working on really, really hard on, okay? But I hear Loki effect, okay? Others of you is, you may end up feeling like, how do I put it? You may be sitting here feeling like, with the love card here, it's about somebody who's actually, I see somebody offering their heart to somebody else. But it's focus on the blessings, not the lessons, because you already learned those lessons from the past. This is not the same. That is the message. Others of you will be taking and you think it's clarity. Now, truthfully, there is one I picked up on that it's going to be February. The clarity is coming. You will get clarity. And it's not, and some of you, if you get clarity this week and you will know, I don't feel no calmness. Okay, you're going to clean house. That's what I get. However that means to you. Now, that's going to affect one. For others of you, if you are feeling, remember I was talking about the Loki effect. We've got clarity, but see the bubble around it? If you feel like everything's not clear to you, just know. Just go through your week. It's just a minute. Okay? It's just a minute. You will be shown the way. Okay? Everything is not quite what it seems. It is. It's Loki effect. I have no doubt. Others of you may actually, you know those days sometimes you're walking around and you feel like you're in a bubble and you can't think whatsoever. I have them, especially how my head is sometimes, especially when I get headaches. But it's kind of like that. Except the only thing is this is like a trickster. Like you're being shown something's not true. That's where I'm supposed to leave it. I'm not going to pull anymore. Yep. Frustration. But really, see? Frustration. But really, there could be happiness. Loki effect. It's not what it seems. So if you need to forgive yourself, or you need to say sorry, or it's vice versa, remember, swallow pride. Swallow the pride, whoever needs to do it, because it's actually focused on the blessings, not the lessons. That's the thing. Because whatever this is, it's just temporary. Temporary. It's just a misunderstanding. You just assume something, or somebody assumes something. That's all it is. Loki effect. Okay. Now, I don't feel like recapping them either because we just did that. So, I have rewind on, Miss Helen. So, yep, focus on, yep, thank you. Okay. Show. Final thoughts for this before I open it up for one card. Okay, and then don't hound it with questions yet because I'll tell you how we're going to do it. What do you need to focus on if you get a moment like that where it's like the Loki effect, where not everything seems you know, it's like not everything's clear. Or you think it's one way, it feels one way, but it actually ends up being a totally different one. Like the King and Queen of Pentacles here. Two peas in a pod, misunderstanding. One sitting over here, this is a new beginning. That's the factual. Well, somebody else is over here. Oh my God, I'm blinded by the situation. I just can't do anything. Oh my God, this is going to be done. Loki effect. When that's not even really what's going on. Do watch for that. However it applies in your life. What do you need to focus on? Okay, number one. There's three of you that's on here right now that have actually been thinking about journaling. You know, you've been having some dreams. Matter of fact, they've been kind of some funky dreams. And, yep. You need to start going to bed. When you take and go to bed, you need to have that journal by you. Okay, because some of you are going to receive the answers of the clarity of the truth of it in your dreams this week. All right? Yep, yep. And whatever this was highlighted around was around the moon. Okay? Because it's actually, some of you, it's actually a feeling you've been having. But then you're going to start dreaming. You need to have that. You need to have it there. Because it may be, you may wake up and you're just like, what does the color green mean? Write it down. You know, and then you end up laying back down. And you're just like, in the morning, what did I? And it's gone. So write it down. All right. The next card right here, your message for the week, is courage. It's also going to hit Leos quite hard. And I do think it's going to hit Leos a lot and Virgos. They're standing out big in my head on this. There's going to be quite a few Virgos. It's going to be. Okay. Virgos, this is not going to go for every one of you, but I don't know which one of you on here, you're a Virgo. I hear no whacking or slapping. Temper. Okay. Anyway, the next card right here, but you need to be focusing on courage. Okay. That's what you get. What? The next card right here is focus on good luck. All right. Before, in the past, you'd be like, okay, I'm going to believe, but it's almost impossible because there's always something stopping me. Do you see this good luck card? Okay, this year is opening doors, but you have to get your balance and your inner peace, period. And you need to put a lot of work into your life this year. And you got family? Yeah, it's about bringing the family on the same level. All right, everybody working together. Peace within the home. Making peace while, even no matter what's going on around you, on the external. That way, I mean, and there's the balance right there. Therefore, 2023 can be the whole year. Well, not the whole year, but basically, you know what? Within self, you can have that peace. And that's what you need to be working on. Focus on the good luck, okay? What you put out is what you're going to attract. If you think everything's going to go to crap in your world, what's going to happen? If you sit back and you're not doing anything or procrastinating on something, you can't be upset because stuff's not going in a positive direction. You have to get up and get the work done. You have to put it out there. Put not just the intentions. You have to put the work in. This year is a year for people to no more just the temporary resolutions. This is about really putting it into action. Backing up the words with the action. Yep. Good luck is yours. That is exactly what you're going to be attracting. And all 2023 is you're going to be attracting what you put out. So, you know, so this next week, definitely focus on your dreams. If you've been having dreams, get a journal, write them down. Others of you, it's going to take a lot of courage to get through this next week, but do it with the heart of a lion. Others of you, put it in your brain right now. Good luck. You know, not everything, oh, that was luck. This was that. No. This is actually focus that you do deserve because you're going to put the work in. Not because you're waiting for it to be dropped on your lap. It's because you're putting the work in. You're putting that intention out and you're backing up that intention. All right? You work on attracting what you want. You want good luck? You want prosperity? Then you have to put the work in. Yep, good luck is yours. All right, that is the end of Coffee Time Tarot. This is how we're going to do it. Don't ask any questions yet. The way we need to do it here is you want one card, put yes. Nothing else, just put yes. This is just I will do one card for each person. Just say yes. Just put it down in the comments and put yes if you want a card pulled. And then at the end, if I by chance miss you, when I say, okay, I'm getting ready to get off, you need to put yes down there, okay, if I missed you. Because sometimes it gets lost. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Who we got here? All right. I'm going to wait for everybody. Go ahead if you want. And make sure you guys, if you want, go ahead and either, you guys are welcome to share my videos. Please like it if you do like it. All right, and then join on Roosters Peacock on Facebook and Coffee Time Tarot. And I'm getting ready to jump over to YouTube, and I'm going to change the name of it just to Roosters Peacock because I'm getting ready to do a lot of stuff on there, guys. Not just for tarot reading, okay? That's not just it. I'm going to show you guys how to, it's about self-sufficiency, which you guys need to put the work in this year. All right, who we got here? All right. Susu, Miss Susu. These are just general, okay? I'm just going to get the general. And I think the way I'm going to do this, it's going to be areas of life or directions you need to go in. Just one card, and I'm just going to give you the feel off of it. Susu. Miss Sue, instantly what I'm getting is your message is being in the flow. Just go with the flow on it. Don't try to fight against whatever's going on. Okay, you can't change the situation right now. Right now, you just need to go with the ebb and flow. That's what I'm hearing. I'm seeing these cards right here in my head as well. So just go with the flow. That is your message for this week. All right, go with the flow. Don't try to fight it. Okay, Miss Helen. Miss Helen, my heart is open, opening to love. Miss Helen, instantly, I think that's not just about the love of another person. If so, apply it how you will, but I really think this is opening to love. My heart is open. I think after a long, it's been a hard past. I think that literally what I'm seeing, sometimes this is how I see it, is this is a heart and there's concrete around it. Yours is starting to crumble off. You are starting to feel again. And I think that at times scares you, but you are on the right path and you're opening yourself up to just self-love, just love in general. And that's as far as I'm going to go. Just general. All right. Miss Phyllis. Do-do-do-do. Phyllis. Miss Phyllis. Let me see that. Miss Phyllis. Miss Phyllis, normally this is just one card, so I'm not going to get real detailed. You actually have two, and they purposely fell. It's just a message. Okay. It's actually a spirit message. It feels like a spirit message. It's talking about, okay, here it is. Okay. So this, it's talking about faith will be restored. That's what I feel. Okay. So we've got receiving the angels. I'm only pulling one card for everybody else. This is supposed to be popping out for her though. You are protected. That's what I get. It says, shimmering wings of angels embrace me with love. Receiving from the angels. This is also talking about faith. This is for Miss Phyllis. Cultivating prosperity. The abundance of the universe is pouring into my life. I think your message is that faith will be restored again after not having it for a while. And this has been something that's been going on for quite a while. That's what I get from that. That was for Miss Phyllis. RMT Ness. All right. One card. Okay, well, you guys saw me shuffle them. Okay, yours as well is go with the flow. Okay, I shuffled them. That is for our empty nest. Our empty nest. Okay, so anyway, yours is I'm in the flow of the universe. It's go with the flow. You're moving on from something. Okay, you're moving on. There's no more. It's kind of like, just along with Coffee Time Tarot. You're thinking on the blessings, not the lessons anymore. You're moving on. I'll look at the other comments. If these resonate with you, go ahead and make sure you let me know at the bottom. I'll look at them here in a little bit. Jeanette Bromley. Miss Jeanette. Miss Ireland, right? Miss Irish. Jeanette. I'll take it. Miss Jeanette. Okay, you guys saw me. I'm shuffling these. A lot of people are going to be focusing on the same things. To a different degree this week. Miss Jeanette, yours is cultivating prosperity, okay? So you are focusing on, I think yours is about an idea you have in your head. I think you already started some work on it, and it was actually last year. Sometimes, and why I'm saying it's maybe it's just the thought. But anyway, you put a lot of thought into it to the point that it's like you've already started this. Whatever you put work into last year, you're going to start seeing a result. But for some reason, I'm looking at the love cards on this. So whatever you've been cultivating in the love field, it's actually going to start trickling in a little bit in a positive direction. Darn it. That was for Miss Jeanette. Miss Carrie Marie. Miss Carrie Marie, your message is trusting your intuition. Just because you can't see everything, you need to go with your gut because it's point on. That is your message. Donnie Parker. Donnie, you've got flying free. Do you see the dove right here? Your message is it's basically moving away from past thoughts or focused on the past and just letting it go. It's actually literally just flying free, moving towards the future, not the past. And it's talking, I unfurl my wings and fly. Okay, so and it's taking off. You're about to take off in a direction. That's what I get. And it's towards the future. You just got to leave the past behind. Okay, let's see. Who's next? Miss Dee Dee. Dee Dee. Miss Dee Dee, you got emerging into grace. I open my soul to grace. Okay, so this one right here, instantly, it's almost like you've been in a sleep and slumber within self. You're about to wake up. That's what I get. You're about to be, you feel like you have your place. You're be finding your place here pretty quick. And you're going to be feeling like you're waking up from a sleep and slumber. It's like coming back to life again. Who do I got here? Miss Misty. I'll only pull one card for each person, okay? If you guys want a full reading on Rooster's Peacock, you guys can get a hold of me there and we can set it up, okay? Miss Misty, embrace your future. You're about to make a decision and walk through a door, okay? But it's not a bad decision. Go ahead and walk through the door. All right. Alex. If you guys do like your readings, please make sure you like the video, okay? You guys are welcome to share it too. Alex. All right. Alex, around the situation in your life, I think you've been waiting for something. You're going to be a lot freer from, you've been feeling quite weighted down by something. You are not going to be feeling like this here pretty soon. Matter of fact, it says soaring into joy. All right. And something that and it says childlike wonder fills my life. Something is going to bring you great joy. And I think it's someone. It's a situation, not just something. It's someone. All right. It's a change of situation. That's what I feel. You're going to be happy here quite quickly. And you're like, no. It's like at one point you thought there was no way out of however you felt about the situation. You're actually going to be feeling much more lighthearted. Okay, who else? That was for Alex. Lucy. You're welcome, Miss Susio. If you're new on here and I haven't picked a card for you, then you need to go ahead and just say yes. That's all you need. Now pick one card. Okay, Miss Lucy. Okay, Miss Lucy, it's going to be, remember the blessings, think on the blessings, not the lessons. That's exactly what you're going to be doing. Remember the luck card right here? Expecting miracles. You're now open. Before, I don't think you were completely open to it, but you're opening back up and ready to receive your blessings. That's what I get. Miracles are blossoming in my life. So do expect around this week, especially in January, just pretty much all January. Even though you might have a little hiccup, and this is going for Miss Lucy, pay attention because those blessings that you've been asking for and that you've kind of changed your thoughts and how you think about stuff, and you're not looking back anymore. I see this before you were in the past. You were looking back. you're not looking back anymore. So you're open for the blessings and you've learned your lessons. Okay, that was for Lucy. Phyllis, you, what's that mean? Jeanette Gromley, did I get you? I think I got you. Yes, I did. You're welcome. Oh, I hope it helped. I think I got Lucy, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Let me see here, guys. Let me see. Carrie Marie. Did that make sense, Alex? You're welcome, Miss Lucy. Okay, did I miss anybody? Because it gets lost in the feed. If you haven't had a card pull, I'll pull one real quick before I hop off here, okay? But all you have to do is just say yes. If I haven't pulled a card. And if you guys, like I said, if you want to catch me on lives, hint, hint, I will be taking, and I've got some more that I'm going to be doing quite quickly. Make sure you like Roosters Peacock on Facebook and Coffee Time Tarot. Don't just follow it. Make sure you like it. And then YouTube, it says Roosters Peacock Tarot. I will be changing that to Roosters Peacock because I also am going to be doing self-sustaining videos, a whole bunch of hacks. I'm an herbalist and aromatherapist as well, okay? And for those of you who have been wanting to have an address, because I was looking for seeds on one of my crazy projects and a whole bunch of other stuff, and some people wanted to give me some letters and cards, I do have a P.O. box. I will attach it to the comments at the end, but it's also on this video. Okay, who we got here? Maggie, Miss Maggie. Your message is letting go, all right? I surrender joyously to the ebbing and flowing of life. I'm telling you, this week, starting tomorrow until the end of Sunday, I think it's going to be all January too. Whatever life brings you, Miss Maggie, go with the flow. And it's showing two people, okay? So whatever comes at you, don't read more into it than what it is. Just go with the flow. It's going to have a Loki effect to it. Go with the flow. Ebb and flow. It's give and take. That's what I keep hearing. Is it Lynn? Miss Lynn. That makes sense, Miss Maggie? It's something that you already kind of aware of. I don't know what it's all about. Well, I do one of those things I have to do a full reading. Miss Maggie. You're welcome. Maggie, you know what? You got that one again. Okay, did I miss anybody? Because I'm going to pop off here. You guys are welcome to share this as much as you want. And like I said, if you haven't liked Rooster's Peacock and Coffee Time Tarot, you might want to do that if you like how I read. And you guys are welcome to take and share this video as much as you want. YouTubers, like I said, this is being done live on Facebook on Rooster's Peacock. All right? And Coffee Time Tarot Group. So, if you guys like my video, please go ahead and make sure you like it. And then I will see you guys on the next time I'm on. So if you guys want to be notified when I'm on, just make sure you hit, make sure you're not just following it, but like it. And it'll pop in your notifications that I go live. Okay? Talk to you guys later. Bye.